Hey guys, it's Abeje’h and today I'm back with another video. Now, I really was contemplating whether I wanted to film this video or not just because of the information that I'm about to say and some of the stuff that I was looking at. But today we're going to talk about, you know, all of the missing women in the U.S. right now and all of the stuff that has been happening with it. You know, I got my notepad, I did all my research, so I have pages in here about some stuff that I would like to say. And I'm going to be eating my jumping both eggs with my beloved sauce. So yeah, let's just hop into the disclaimer. I'm not an expert. Some people might find this content offensive, or it may be sensitive to some of you. And if you're sensitive to some stuff, then maybe you shouldn't watch this video. If you would like to know the information I'm about to say and the things I found and how it could help you maybe one day if you're faced with this situation, then just keep watching. Okay, so first I want to start off by saying, I have the percentage of all the missing women by race. So for white, there's 362,988. For black, there's 207,394. Unknown is 19,556. For Asian is 12,994. Indian is 9,914. Okay, now what I want to say is I don't agree with the way that this is categorized, because for one, Hispanic people, when you guys go missing and when they try to calculate it, they throw you in with the white people. So this number for whites that is missing is white and Hispanic people. So that's probably not even a full accurate number of how many Hispanic people are missing and how many white people are missing, just because they put you guys in the same category. So with this, technically, it can mean that there's more black people missing than any other race just because of the way that it is categorized. And this, there is not a number for how many Hispanic people are missing without the white people, but they have numbers of how many white people live in the country, how many white people and Hispanic people live in the country. So they have two separate numbers for that, but they do not have an accurate number for how many are missing. Okay, so I also looked up, you know, the population of how much each of us make. White people make up 60% of the U.S. population with 197 million, which is also including the number of Hispanic people. Black people only make up 14% of the U.S. population, which is 42 million people. Asian people make up 17.3 million people. That's 5.6% of the U.S. population. And Indians, there's only 5.2 million of Indians here. And 78% of them live on reservations, which is their own land, because, you know, the government wanted to be greedy and wanted to take up all the land and push them out of the country. So they only make up about 1.6% of the population. Okay. So that's how many people are in this country, you know, including the race. Okay. Females under 21, 211,906. 21 and over is 98,611. Now, these numbers, in my opinion, are very, very inaccurate, and I'm gonna explain why. And again, like I said, this is my opinion. You don't have to agree with me. You can agree, you can disagree. I really don't care. But the reason I said this is inaccurate is because, for one, white people and Hispanic people are categorized in the same context when it comes to stuff like this. That is very inaccurate, because Hispanic people do not have a set number of how many of them are missing, but there's a set number of how many of them there is in this country. Two, this unknown race. That could be multiracial people, you know, that could be any race of people, but they just put it in the unknown category, which I honestly don't think is right. They should have done more research with that part to figure out what category to put them people in, because, you know, we don't know. It could be multiracial people, it could not be, because it just says unknown. Now, what I also want to get into is, you know, how do how do I say this? Undocumented citizens here. Okay, so undocumented people here make up about 10.5 million of them in the United States. They make up about 3.2% of the population. So that's more than Native Americans here that's in this country. Now, because these people are undocumented, just imagine when their children go missing. They don't report it to the authorities because they're afraid that they're going to get arrested or they're going to get deported. So a lot of these cases go unreported just because of fear of parents getting deported, you know, and other stuff like that. Just like when that mass shooting happened in Texas, a lot of them didn't go to the hospital because they were undocumented and they didn't want to get deported. So we have things like this that is happening here. A lot of these people, we don't know. Like, the immigrants, their children could also be missing. So they could also fit in this unknown category. We don't know. But since their parents probably are scared to report it, we will never know, because they don't want to get deported or they just have fears of being arrested. Okay, now, a lot of this is leading to sex trafficking, which is a multi-billion dollar industry. Multi-billion dollars. Now, there's different levels to sex trafficking. A lot of people just think they're just going to kidnap you and just sell you to this person, that person. No, it doesn't happen like that. Sometimes it does, but a lot of the times it does not happen like that. I know you guys have seen the movie I Spilled in Your Grave 2, when they kidnapped that girl. Well, she went to a photo shoot to get pictures done. The guy followed her back to her place and was in her house, and then he raped her, and then they kidnapped her and they sent her to a different country, and they was basically selling her off to people. I'm gonna insert a clip to that video.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, shit! What would you say to me? Oh, God! Oh, Jesus! Oh, God!
It's date night.
Hello?
That's great.
Can I help you?
Katie,
you are much prettier than pictured.
Sometimes stuff like that happens. And you know the movie Taken, when the man's daughter got kidnapped and they were selling her for hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Dad!
Oh, my darling.
Happy birthday.
Dad, guess what?
Mm-hmm.
You know my friend Amanda?
Yep.
Her cousins asked us to spend vacation with them in Paris. I really, really want to go. Hi, Daddy.
You were supposed to call me when you land.
There's someone here.
What?
Oh, my God, they got Amanda. They're coming.
All right, listen to me. Go to the next bedroom, under the bed.
Tell me when you're there.
I can't.
Now, the next part is very important. They're going to take you. I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you are looking for a ransom, I can tell you I don't have money, but what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
Where are they?
If you let my daughter go now, that'll be the end of it.
You have a 96 hour
to what?
To never finding her.
No.
But if you don't, I will look for you.
Where is she?
I will find you. I will kill you.
Good luck.
That also happens too. They're kidnapping these women. They're selling them for, they actually sell them for millions of dollars. And you know, if you're a virgin, your virginity gets, you know, because you're a virgin, they sell you for a higher price because, you know, nobody has had you yet. So they sell these women for millions of dollars. Okay, now this is not even just the fucked up part. You know, they just are selling them for money. So they make $150 billion a year for sex trafficking. And $99 billion comes from the sexual exploitation. And you know, this number has increased 13% since 2017. So a lot of people saying, oh, it's just happening, you know, it's just recent. No, this has been happening, but the numbers are becoming higher. And I know you guys, where you live, you have been seeing a lot more people getting kidnapped, a lot more women getting snatched up, getting put into sex trafficking rings. I know you guys seen stories on social media about women who are being approached and stuff. And honestly, you know, it's crazy that women have to now take more caution to protect themselves. Even if you're a woman, you still should protect yourself. Men too, especially little boys, because they're taking little boys now as well. So if you have a little son, you need to try to make sure that he is protected. You need to make sure that he knows what to do, you know, teach him how to protect himself and how to be safe because of what they're doing now. Okay, so with the sex trafficking, a lot of it happens in the U.S., so a lot of it is domestic that's happening here. Sometimes the women are getting sold out of country, but a lot of the times it's domestic. Now, who are they selling these women to? Most of the customers are white men or rich men because they have a disposable amount of income. So they can sell them to these men because, you know, they have the money for it. They can spend thousands of dollars on these women and not feel it because, you know, they have the money for it. So these are the main buyers, are the rich, wealthy white men or people with money. These are the people that are buying these women. A lot of them are married. They have big businesses. They're probably politicians. You know, a lot of these men are very, very wealthy. So they have a good amount of income. Okay. How they target these women? They target adults in poverty. They target homeless women. And the foster care, people that are in foster care. And I know you know the foster care system has failed a lot of people in this country. People go because their parents are being abusive towards them or just treating them badly. They go to these people and the same thing happens. You know, they sell them to other people. DFACS doesn't really come and watch the kids how they're supposed to. They don't go and inspect the houses how they're supposed to. So these kids are just being left with anybody. Any type of people can do whatever they want to these people. Okay. Now, think about this. The foster system is ran by the government. So why aren't these kids getting the proper care that they need? Why aren't these kids being cared for the way that they should be cared for? And these little kids that you see on social media, they're all being groomed for this stuff. These little girls that are posing half naked. And people say, you know, don't let your children dress like this. Don't let your child wear stuff like this, you know. We shouldn't sexualize kids. But in a day where stuff is getting like this, you need to be really, really careful of how you are dressing your child and how children should be looking. And don't let your kids go anywhere by themselves. And not even safe for kids to walk to their bus stops or from their bus stops by themselves or to school and from school because of this crap that is happening. I'm gonna insert some screenshots that I found on Instagram of people telling their stories and blur out their names so that they maybe don't want their identity exposed. So I'm gonna blur out their names so people don't figure out who they are. But these are just some of their stories from well, they almost were abducted. Okay, this next stuff that I'm about to say is mostly for African American women and Hispanic women and children. Look out for this part that I'm about to say, because this could help you a lot. Okay, so suspects get less time in jail when they kidnap, abduct, and sex traffic African American women. That's the reason why a lot of them are missing, because they get less jail time when they kidnap them and sell them off. They can get probation. They get less time than if it was a white woman. So that's why a lot of them target African American women, because they target them because it's less jail time for them. Also, you know, when they go to court, the judge paints them as a prostitute and not a victim of sex trafficking, not someone who was kidnapped. They just paint them as a prostitute, saying that this person willingly went and was doing this stuff. A lot of times they don't have a choice, but this is how they paint it in court. This is why these men are getting away with it, because they're not viewing Black and Hispanic women as victims. They're viewing them as women who are, you know, just selling their bodies, that have not been kidnapped or been forced into that lifestyle. Okay. And a lot of the times when the men who are selling them, if they happen to be wealthy or white men, you know, they just get sent, they don't even get sentences, they just get programs or they get probation. They just make them do classes. Like, nothing bad happens to them for real. But yeah, they don't view these women as victims. They view them as, you know, the aggressor. They view them as the person who put themselves in that predicament. Also, watch out for people putting zip ties on your cars. Watch out for pieces of paper on your cars, because it's just a distraction to try to kidnap you. Watch out for these people who are talking about church. I've had a guy at my job actually come and talk to me about church. I thought he was a good guy, but I just also thought it was really, really creepy, because he just kept saying stuff like, you're so pretty, you're so tall, you know, stuff like that. That really kind of caught me off guard. So I called my boyfriend and he brought me a knife to my work so that I could carry it around. And now I've been carrying that knife ever since, just because crazy stuff has been happening. So watch out for those type of people who talk to you about church. Also, watch out for people who try to seem vulnerable and that need help. Remember Ted Bundy? I think that's his name. He would wear canes and walkers and act like he needed help into cars and would kidnap these women and stuff. Watch out for people like that, you know, because women are naturally sensitive. We're naturally nice to people. So when we see people who need help, we automatically want to help. Women, you can't do that now. You got to put yourself first. You cannot watch out for these people. You need to just make sure that you can just get from point A to point B. Try not to go out super, super late at night, because now it's really, really scary, the stuff that they're doing to us, because, you know, we're women. But you guys gotta watch out for it. In my opinion, I also don't believe that it's just sex trafficking. There's other types of illegal trafficking and stuff that happens in this country that makes also a lot of money. You guys can do your research on that, because I don't really want to get into this topic. This is just for sex trafficking and for women and girls to just protect themselves. Hold on. I also seen a post about a baby crying at night. If you hear a baby crying at night and you're outside of your house, don't try to go get it. Just leave it. Just call the cops. You know, it's a lot of ways that they're getting women out here, you guys. You guys just have to stay safe. Trust your gut. And stop meeting people online. If you talk to somebody online and you never met them, don't meet up with them. Just don't. And a lot of them, they have been using fake apps, text people from regular numbers. I'll insert some screenshots from that as well. there have been people who've been getting text messages from their moms and their parents didn't send them, you know, tell them to come outside, saying they're in this car, they're in that car, or tell them to drop their kids off there. Guys, don't trust it. They're getting really, really crafty with how they're trying to take women and stuff. So you guys have to be on the lookout. You cannot let these people get you. Carry pepper spray, carry a taser. Choice TV says bear spray, get some bear spray. If you don't want to buy that spray, make your own spray. Take some wasp spray and some bleach and mix it together. It might blind them motherfuckers, but guess what? At least you'll be safe. And you shouldn't give a damn if you blind them anyways because they're targeting you. And if you're old enough, please get a license to carry a gun. Please. And I know sometimes, like, if they try to kidnap you and you shoot them, it's a 50-50 chance if you'll get off from it, just because how can you prove that they tried to kidnap you? You know, so we're actually in, I don't know, it's really, really hard to try to protect yourself now, just because, you know, they're always against, everything's always against women, especially women of color. We always have a hard time proving stuff, you know. And with stuff like this happening, who's gonna believe us? Especially when you guys are selling us off. You guys are getting less jail time because you're selling women of color. And stuff like that. Like, nobody wants to listen to stuff like that, you know? And they take these women, they sell them for millions and millions of dollars. And a lot of times you can't trust the police either because they're in on it too. Like how they be on these drug trades and stuff. These people are also paying the cops.
You have been nothing but a positive force in my life. She's one.
Happy birthday, B.
It's your dream car.
It's amazing.
Let's get away from the city.
Oh my gosh.
It's miles away from everything.
It's a celebration.
I did not know you guys were coming.
I'm trying to create a moment. I want to give her something she can remember for the rest of her life.
You never cease to amaze me. What are you looking at?
You.
That is a hot rod.
Built it myself.
Where'd you learn that? The prison auto shop? Sweet ride, smoking peas in the store. You a ball player?
Not looking for any trouble.
Trouble? Can't hold a polite conversation.
Oh my God.
Car, get your...
Give me a minute. Sorry.
What are you doing in here?
Okay.
Let's go. Now.
Okay.
We've got a big problem. Can't find the phone.
People I work for do not accept mistakes.
It's crazy. Hey, baby, your phone is ringing.
That's not my phone. Hey, that girl. Something in my gut was telling me that she needed help.
I think I put my phone in your bag by accident.
Let me help you.
Just give me the phone. Just give me the phone, okay?
He will kill you.
Hold on! Wait.
Hey, you got something that belongs to me.
They're gonna kill us.
I need help right now, please. I don't know where I'm at.
Where are you, little lady?
Stop!
Now I'm gonna keep you just for me. Just for me.
Birthday, Sarah.
Sarah, you've aged out of foster care.
And the state law is that you have to leave the group home tomorrow.
Hey! Hey,
girl! Hey, girl!
You both owe me 500 men. When you're with one, you smile, enjoy it. If you don't enjoy it, lie. Make them think you enjoy it.
Welcome to Texas.
Hi.
I'm Sarah. God, Thomas.
What is that horn in the middle of the night?
The train. There's a freight line just about a mile north of here.
Don't think about who you used to be.
You have to keep that other girl buried far away.
Because in here, she'll drive you mad.
We're going.
Going where?
Home.
No! You just obey the rules. You break them, we're gonna break you.
I am sure that Sarah is just fine.
If you think that these people are making billions of dollars, why wouldn't they pay off a cop a couple thousand, a couple hundred thousand to shut up and not say nothing about what they're doing to people? Think about it. Women, you have to protect yourselves. You cannot trust nobody when it comes to stuff like this. Like, you gotta be really cautious. You have to be really careful. So yeah, that's just what I wanted to say in this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And remember to protect yourself at all times. Be cautious. Be aware of your surroundings. You know, don't go nowhere late at night. Don't try to be super nice to people. You know, don't let anyone try to take advantage of you. Just take care of yourself and yourself only. So I'll see you guys later.